The MCA Namibia Compact was signed in July 2008 to develop Namibia's agricultural, education and tourism sectors for a period of 5 years only. However, the implementation of its projects in the country only started in 2009, following initial doubts about its true intentions. Those doubts were eventually cleared, and to date, about 35 billion Namibian dollars has been invested in the development of the Etosha National Park through the construction of staff villages, road upgrading and others. Deputy MCA Namibia CEO Sikongo Haihambo says the entity is on track and all the projects implemented were Namibian conceptualized, based and owned.
We have upgraded schools, we have built Costex, we have constructed super libraries, the so-called regional study and resource centers in three towns as we speak. We have constructed SVO state veterinary offices. We are busy with staff housing in the Etosha National Park, management centers, which are also under construction. We have procured and continue to procure textbooks.
MCA Namibia funding has seen 47 schools upgraded, benefiting 24,900 learners, 85 water points established, and 5 veterinary offices constructed, among many other projects. MCA Namibia resident coordinator Stefan Dobrilovic says, back in Washington, D.C., the Namibian Compact is considered one of the best and with few problems.
You should feel assured that the money that is coming from the U.S. taxpayer here is being used appropriately, and it's being spent for the benefit of the people. So I just wanted to let you know that that's the view from Washington.
If the MCA funds are not all fully utilized by September next year, they will be returned to the U.S. Treasury. But MCA Namibia is optimistic that that is unlikely to happen, as 92% of such funds have already been committed. The compact is coming to an end in September next year. But MCA says it is working hard to ensure that the benefits continue to flow to the Namibian communities in the quest for poverty reduction through economic growth. Tonate Nishidudu, NBC News, Windhoek.